Good morning, and welcome to our Sunday morning live streamed worship here at Church of the Holy Communion. A special welcome to all of our friends and church family, to those who are our ministry partners out at St. Thomas Somerville and Emmanuel LaGrange, and especially to any who may be visiting or viewing with us for the first time this morning. We would love to get to know you better and connect a little bit, so if you'd like, please do reach out via email or in the chat comments, and we will be in touch to connect and get to know you a little bit better. Please also keep an eye out this afternoon for a message from about reentry to the church from our rector, the Reverend Sandy Webb, that will come by email, and we'll share some details I know many of you are excited to know about and learn about. We will begin and continue our worship with hymn number 214. Alleluia. Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Christ has entered not into a sanctuary made with hands, a copy of the true one, but into heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God on our behalf. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Lord, open our lips, and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Let us say together the Passion Nostrum. Alleluia, the Lord is risen indeed. Come, let us adore him. Alleluia. Alleluia. Christ our Passover has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast, not with the old leaven, the leaven of malice evil, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Alleluia. Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death that he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So also consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Alleluia. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so also in Christ shall all be made alive. Alleluia. The portion of the Psalter appointed for this morning is Psalm 68, verses 1 through 10 and 33 through 36. Let us say it together. Let God arise, and let his enemies be scattered. Let those who hate him flee before him. Let them vanish like smoke when the wind drives it away, as the wax melts at the fire. So let the wicked perish at the presence of God. But let the righteous be glad and rejoice before God. Let them also be merry and joyful. Sing to the God, sing praises to his name. Exalt him who rides upon the heavens. Yahweh is his name. Rejoice before him. Father of orphans, defender of widows, God in his holy habitation. God gives the solitary a home and brings forth prisoners into freedom, but the rebels shall live in dry places. O God, when you went forth before your people, when you marched through the wilderness, the earth shook and the skies poured down rain at the presence of God, the God of Sinai, at the presence of God, the God of Israel. You sent a gracious rain, O God, upon your inheritance. You refreshed the land when it was weary. Your people found their home in it. In your goodness, O God, you have made provision for the poor. Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth. Sing praises to the Lord. He rides in the heavens, the ancient heavens. He sends forth his voice, his mighty voice. Ascribe power to God. His majesty is over Israel. His strength is in the skies. How wonderful is God in his holy places. The God of Israel, giving strength and power to his people. Blessed be God. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. A reading from Acts. When the apostles had come together, they asked Jesus, Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel? He replied, It is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going and they were gazing up toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. Then they returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they had entered the city, they went to the room upstairs where they were staying, Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James, son of Alphaeus, and Simon the Zealot, and Judas, son of James. All these were constantly devoting themselves to prayer, together with certain women, including Mary, the mother of Jesus, as well as his brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us say together the Benedictus Dominus Deus. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. A reading from John. Jesus looked up to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son so that the Son may glorify you, since you have given him authority over all people, to give eternal life to all whom you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth by finishing the work that you gave me to do. So now, Father, glorify me in your own presence with the glory that I had in your presence before the world existed. I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything you have given me is from you. For the words that you gave to me, I have given to them, and they received them, and know in truth that I came from you, and they believed that you sent me. I am asking on their behalf. I am not asking on behalf of the world, but on behalf of those whom you gave me, because they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us say together the Dignus Est. Splendor and honor and kingly power are yours by right, O Lord our God, for you created everything that is, and by your will they were created and have their being. And yours by right, O Lamb that was slain, for with your blood you have redeemed for God, from every family, language, people, and nation, a kingdom of priests to serve our God. And so to him who sits upon the throne, and to Christ the Lamb, be worship and praise, dominion and splendor, forever and forevermore. Alleluia. Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. We'll just have to wait and see.
I know.
Yeah. Can you just hear the ellipses in that phrase trailing off into forever?
No, thanks.
I'm not even referring to any specific current context. That phrase is bothersome and applicable. Pretty much always. And it's pretty nearly always. Ugh.
Am I right?
Humans are not, in my experience, by and large, great at waiting, or at least doing it well, which is ironic, given that most of us will have a fair amount of time to practice at it. It goes without saying, we don't generally enjoy it. We pick at it, worry, lose sleep over it. And I can blame consumerism, fast food, or Jeff Bezos as much as I want, but they're only giving us what we asked for, which is exactly my every whim and desire in 2 days or less, at least as long as I can pay. It's perhaps instructive that there's a lot about waiting in our faith and scripture. People waiting on God to act, to deliver, to save. And our liturgical cycle pretty regularly deals with waiting. Advent is about repentance and rejoicing and hope, but also waiting. It even comes with a countdown calendar filled with chocolate, if you're very lucky. Lent is about repenting and wandering and tidying, but also waiting for Easter. This week, between the Feast of the Ascension, which was this past Thursday, and Pentecost, which is a week from this Sunday, the disciples and friends of Jesus are waiting again too. Ascension is a principal feast, the critical celebrations and remembrances of the church year, and also one that, for whatever reason in our current calendar, gets perhaps the shortest shrift. Maybe because it happens on a Thursday, maybe because down here at least, it's right when end of the school year stuff is normally in full swing and summer plans and activities normally are beginning. It's critical theologically because it's the completion of the first arc of God's salvation in Christ. God became incarnate in Jesus, lived among us, died and rose, freeing us from the bondage of death, was among us again, and then ascended into heaven, interceding for us at the right hand of God the Father and assuring us of his presence with and among us in all times and all places. We then look to the day, as the creeds say, when Jesus will come again and usher in the fullness God has brought about in salvation. Today's reading from the Acts of the Apostles is much of the passage that we read on Thursday. The evangelist Luke, who wrote Acts also, notes that in the 40 days after Easter, Jesus continued to appear among his disciples, continuing to teach and talk about the kingdom of God, preparing them for what was to come next, which apparently they still needed a little coaching on. Is this, parentheses, finally, when you'll restore the kingdom of Israel, parentheses, and kick the Romans out? They asked Jesus. No, Jesus says, or rather, that's beyond what is ours to know, even though we want to, and even though we hope not to have to wait. But Jesus won't leave us without resources or without purpose. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. Then whoosh, up into the air like Elijah. Understandably, the apostles are still looking up when angels appear to helpfully get them on their way. Don't get distracted. You have your marching orders, they seem to say. They assure the disciples that God in Christ, who has returned to home in heaven, will come back in the same way to make home among mortals. They return again, the disciples, to the upstairs room with their full community of fellow followers, and they settle in to pray and to wait for the arrival of the Holy Comforter, the Spirit of God. Our collect of the day today is one of my favorites. Do not leave us comfortless, but send your Holy Spirit to strengthen us and exalt us to that place where our Savior Christ has gone before.
that a prayer for the times? All times, really. Waiting on the news. Waiting on the seed to bloom. Waiting for something to change when you're only just making it through the day. Waiting for the call with the biopsy results. Waiting for something to give. For a break to come. It's been a hard couple of months for many people, and for many, they've only made what was already hard harder. If isolation has made some sadness or anxiety or any other burden even harder, and you've been carrying it alone, I hope you'll reach out to me or to any of the clergy. We probably can't fix whatever's wrong, but we can wait together. We can pray together. Lord, do not leave us comfortless, but send us your Holy Spirit to strengthen us and exalt us to that place where our Savior Christ has gone before. We hold to the hope that God heals and brings wholeness in Christ. Many of us can share stories of where God has done so in our lives. And so we can't just keep watch or pray in the upper room. Those remain essential parts for what comes next, but there is that last part of the job. A group of us have been reading and reflecting upon the whole book of the Acts of the Apostles on Wednesday nights. And we've noted especially that the Holy Spirit is a protagonist after Pentecost, with Peter and Paul and the others following along afterwards. One of my scripture professors in seminary described the subtitle to Acts as Church on the Move. Being witnesses to the ends of the earth means we may go places we didn't plan to go and may have to speak truth even when not convenient. And this is a challenge when our culture privileges our individual wills and desires, mostly because it then wants to sell us things based on those desires. As a part of the church, it's always a good time to ask of ourselves, how are we being led by the Spirit? But especially amidst turbulent times. So you're right, all the time. How are we being led by the Spirit? How do we listen? How do we know and differentiate when the voice we're hearing is the Spirit of God instead of just our own wills and hopes and desires? Or even the voice of the adversary? These are questions for Pentecost, and the Acts of the Apostles is a good place to see some examples. We worship and wait. We gather and pray. Then we witness when the Spirit leads. We will not be left comfortless, but our own comfort cannot be our guiding star, nor can we be complacent, even when the waiting feels overlong. So where is the Spirit leading us to be witnesses? A beautiful parish, a loving and welcoming community, these are wonderful things, gifts from God that are sanctuaries, but also tools. How will they help us comfort the comfortless? How will they help us bear witness to what God has done and is doing and will do? What borders and boundaries is the Spirit empowering us to cross? How is the Spirit helping us grow, not into nice or even good people, but into reconciling people? Disciples of the one who reconciled us to God and each other and asked us to continue to witness and even take part in that vocation. There are times of waiting, Lord knows. And it's always a good time to pray together. But if you're tired of the waiting, if you're ready to get on the move too, take heart. The Spirit soon beckons. What do you hear? Where are we going next? Alleluia. Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Let us now say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Clothe your ministers with righteousness. Let your people sing with joy. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world, for only in you can we live in safety. Lord, keep this nation under your care, and guide us in the way of justice and truth. Let your way be known upon earth, your saving help among all nations. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and sustain us with your Holy Spirit. O God, the King of glory, you have exalted your only Son, Jesus Christ, with great triumph to your kingdom in heaven. Do not leave us comfortless, but send your Holy Spirit to strengthen us and exalt us to that place where our Savior Christ has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, in glory everlasting. Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in you we live and move and have our being. We humbly pray you so to guide and govern us by your Holy Spirit, that in all the cares and occupations of our life we may not forget you, but may remember that we are ever walking in your sight through Jesus Christ, our Lord. O God, you have made of one blood all the peoples of the earth, and sent your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your fold. Pour out your Spirit upon all flesh, and hasten the coming of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Your own prayer intentions are invited at this time, aloud or in the silence of your hearts. You may write in your prayer requests via the church streams. You may also email private prayer requests directly to the clergy. During the offering that is about to be played, we make our offerings to the church, and you may do that through the following electronic means, through our website, holycommunion.org/give, or by texting CHC or using the QR code that is found in your bulletins right there. We are grateful to be able to continue our work of ministry together.
Oh.
Say together the general thanksgiving. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all of your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. You have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Amen. Today is one of our special days to bless the good works of the knitting ministry, who knit these beautiful bears and shawls and soft cushies for to be given to people who are in need of a little bit of comfort, who need to know that their prayers, that they are surrounded literally in the prayers of their church family, from our knitting guild and for all of us who hold each other in prayer. So, I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God. He has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness. O God, you revealed your Son clothed in majesty and glory. Accept these prayer shawls, warming, comforting, enfolding, and embracing. May each be a mantle of safe haven and a sacred place of security, which sustains and embraces in good times and in difficult times, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May God bless them to the use of all to whom they are given. May they know God's love when they are comforted and surrounded by their warmth. And may God also bless us, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us all and remain with us always.
Amen.
In the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.